everybody, Dave here from British Trucking. If you're new to the channel, welcome. First day back after bank holiday. I'm currently on my way to a place called Tattenhall, which is in Cheshire. So I'll be driving from Ellesmere in Shropshire via Whitchurch, and then we'll be going down the A41 to Tattenhall. See what we encounter on the way. Put my dash cam in the rear window today just to see what that looks like. I normally have it on the front windscreen, but I see some other truckers on YouTube have it in their back windows, which looks pretty cool. Truck drivers like Luke C, which is very popular British driver with an amazing channel. You want to check it out? It's good. And all the legends. Quite a good weekend. I went to the Shrewsbury Steam Rally, which was pretty cool. A lot of old vintage trucks there, and which I did do a video on with some photographs of some cool looking vintage trucks, Fodens and Commas and all sorts of things. If you want to check that out. Some of you older boys might have even driven them. I know there was a couple there that I'd driven. Makes you feel old when you're walking around them and you see trucks there that you've driven in the past. They had classic cars there as well. There was a lot of them that I'd owned in the past. My first car was a Mark 1 Escort. I wish I had it now, the value they are. But yeah, it was a good show. My little girl with me, and she went on the fair rides. The carousel. Steam carousel. That was quite nice to see. Now called Welsh Hampton. If anybody ever drives this way, just be careful, because there's usually a speed van at the end of it. Which I know none of you speed, and I'm sure it won't be an issue, but it's nice to know it's there. Quaint little village. Sun Inn Pub. I used to play pool there when I was a bit younger than I am now. let me know in the comments below if you think my dash cam's better in the back window or in the front window. I haven't done many driving videos, but it'd be nice to get it positioned correctly where it shows everything better. If you're a new driver just starting out, it's good to watch some of these videos. Just give you some sort of inclination as to what we get up to during our working day. Some of the things we encounter. Don't know, I'm currently driving a concrete mixer. British Trucking's also got a Facebook group if you want to go and join that, enter into the discussion. Truck drivers are welcome. It's nice to get other people's opinions on things. It's, we're all in the same boat, and I'm sure we all don't know everything, so it's quite nice if somebody has a question that they want to put up on the Facebook group, then I'm sure somebody will answer the question for you. And of course there's the British Trucking website as well, where you can get some great gear for yourself or your truck. That's britishtrucking.co.uk. Check that out. It's a bit overcast today. It was a beautiful weekend for a bank holiday. Cloudy today. Now I'm back at work, which I suppose isn't too bad really. It can get a bit hot in the cab. Dash cam that I'm using at the moment, I'm really pleased with it actually. The Ape Man Mini. It's quite a small dash cam, it's quite cool. It doesn't take up any space. The quality I think is pretty good for the money. They are available on the website. Little plug. starting to rain. Long to go now, and we'll find out what's happening with Brexit. I wish they'd do something with it, because I'm sick of hearing about Brexit. If you've got any opinions on that, why don't you leave them in the comments below? Let's see what your opinions are on Brexit. Whether you think we should stay, or whether you think we should go. First heard about it, I thought, oh, great, I'll get rid of that EU 30-minute break that we've got to take. We could just get back to 45 minutes. But apparently it's staying, even if we leave. Boris has got better ideas, of course. If he can't get his deal through, perhaps he'll see his art and get things back to how they were. Traffic about this morning. We're now coming down to the Redbrook Junction. Anybody knows the area? Used to be the Redbrook Hotel on the right, but that's now being turned into something else, as a lot of things are. to Whitchurch. Church, because we're turning off to go on to the 41 to go to Tattenhall, which will be the Chester Road. MOT last week, and there's something rattling in the cab which is doing my head in, so I'm going to have to have a look under the seat later and see what's been disturbed. Maybe the towing pin or something that's rattling. Thank you. A41's quite a busy road. But you've got the two roads running parallel with each other, the A41 and the A49, so you tend to get a lot of traffic coming up from the Midlands, going up north, heading towards the M56 or the M53 going up towards Liverpool, that sort of direction. Outside Tattenhall, because we don't actually drive the trucks through the village, because it's quite a peaceful little village and wouldn't be fair to have trucks going through there all day, so we sort of go around Tattenhall and then come into the plant that way. If anybody is from around the northwest of England, you might have heard of somewhere called the Ice Cream Farm, which if you've got children is a really good day out, and it's free to get in. Can you believe that? Somewhere is free. They sell a lot of ice creams, mind you, but it's good fun for the children. They love it. Lots to do there. Good food there too. If you're looking for a day out anytime, I would definitely recommend the Ice Cream Farm. Just up the road from there, there's a place called Crocky Trails, which I took my little girl to just a couple of weeks ago, and that is a really good fun day out. Good attractions within sort of probably about 4 or 5 miles of each other, so if you do fancy a good day out sometime with the kids, we definitely recommend that. roundabout shortly called Broxton Roundabout. Quite a popular truck stop at the 41. They do a mean bacon sandwich and they do a pretty good cheeseburger too. Worth checking out. Obviously, I have to go to the gym after, of course. Broxton Roundabout. If you're ever coming down the 41 towards Chester, come up to Broxton Roundabout. If you take a left and then take a left into the car park, then it's a good little truck stop there, a good burger van. Signs that say road closed ahead and you haven't got a clue which road it is, whether it's a side road or whether it's the main road that you're driving on. It's not very clear, is it? Go up to the sign and you're panicking, thinking, do I carry on, do I carry on? And then you find it's a little side road that's closed. see a lit up sign. Road closed for two nights. See what I mean? At Roxton roundabout there, there was a red sign saying road closed ahead. And then you come to a sign which says road closed for two nights on such and such a date. Road surface. They've obviously got more money in Cheshire than they have in Shropshire. All we get is potholes. The problem with having road ahead closed signs like that, and then you find that there's little lanes on the right or the left that are closed off, is going to be almost like leaving your beacons on. People are going to start ignoring the signs because they're not going to know what it's actually telling them. I think they need to change that system of road signage, to be honest. One, it's going to, when the road is actually closed ahead, it's going to cause you all sorts of problems. Right, we're turning right now towards Tattenhall. Soon, because we're not far off where I'm loading, so I will sign off and hopefully see you in the next video. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Give us a thumbs up and don't forget to comment below about some of the things we've been talking about. Well, I've been talking about, because I'm always rabbiting up. Particularly road closed signs. Because they really annoy me. Right, we'll see you in the next video. Bye for now.